Hey, y'all. Do you like beer?
Do you like duck?
Did you know you can put a beer into a duck and then put it on a barbecue and have beer can duck? We didn't know it, but we're gonna try it today. Let's do this. Prime time, baby.
We're back.
You've had beer can chicken. You've made it a lot.
Sure have.
I've eaten it a bunch. We've never done beer can duck though. And today we're gonna try and figure it out.
Our crew is safe. Ben and I have seen way too much of each other over the past 6 months. We are going to remove our masks. Is that okay with you?
That's okay with me, and there is no one else here.
Be responsible.
Be responsible.
Oh, that's what you look like?
That was just mean.
Beer can chicken, super duper delicious. However, the only downside is that the skin on the chicken doesn't get super duper crispy. We want crispy skin!
We do.
We're thinking we can do a beer can duck, which has thicker skin, and actually get really crispy, perfectly cooked duck. I've never done this before. Have you done this before?
Never done it. Kenji Lopez Alt has done it.
Sorry, Kenji.
We're here to live and learn, man. We're here to live and learn. So in a previous episode of Decoy, Chef Joe Ng showed us how to make Peking duck. Part of that technique is separating the skin to get it crispy. I don't think anyone would argue that you can find a crispier skin than Peking duck. You can't. That said, we are not making Peking duck. But as you can only get the crispiest skin using certain techniques, we're gonna try those out and apply them to see if they also work on a beer can duck recipe.
So in order to do this properly, we need to go back in time.
Okay, here we are. Don't know what that was, but it happened.
24 hours from now,
yes,
we're gonna need to cook a duck.
So now we're gonna do the things for tomorrow, but do them today.
All right, so what we're about to do is try to separate the skin from the meat. We learned how to do this from Chef Joe using an air compressor. We got a bike pump. The air pump alone is not gonna work.
Right.
We have two large holes.
We're not gonna sew up the back end because we're putting a beer can in there, so we have air coming out of there. Second, we don't have the full neck, so there's a lot of air pockets in the front. I think we could use the knife though at the same time. Like, you can kind of clear a path with your hand,
mm-hmm.
and then you can kind of feel like where your sticking points are.
So let's just try a paring knife to see whether or not we can open this.
Mm-hmm.
Wanna try to pump it again?
Let's go for it.
I think we did actually, that actually worked. We separated the fat from the meat.
We're gonna head over to our giant steam kettle. We'll dip them in water. That'll tighten the skin back up. Then we're gonna give them a quick vinegar and sugar bath, hang them, and forget about them until tomorrow. So as you can see, we've let the ducks hang out for 24 hours. They hung for another 24 hours, and you can see the skin looks like we never touched it, but it is actually still separated. It's just got tighter. So how do we want to season these guys?
I think just salt. We'll see whether that works to just caramelize the skin.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll also pick two different beers to see if there's a difference between a light beer and a dark beer. Going inside, going in. Ooh, wow.
Oh boy, I got a lot of salt in that neck.
Salty neck.
Okay, feel pretty good about that.
Cool.
Good amount of salt in there.
Yeah, and I think the only other thing we need to do is just trim up the tail here in order for it to actually sit upright.
Mm-hmm.
Our legs will help us balance, but we got a little too much tail
going
on there.
Great. You wanna take off the neck fat on that one?
Let's take the neck fat off on this one. There's a little hole right here. That way we'll see whether there's a difference in of this excess fat.
Cool. So that one will have an opening for the steam to come out.
Great, looking good.
And then this guy, we'll just take the tail off. We'll leave the neck fat folded over to hold the steam inside.
Cool.
Cool.
All right, looks great.
All right, two ducks, slightly different to see how they'll steam as well.
Beer time!
Beer time.
I'd like to do like a nice quality, crisp light beer. And then I think we should see
if there's a difference with like a more aggressive, heavy, hazy
IPA.
IPA, bruh.
Okay. Hazy IPA boy. Crispy boy.
Crispy boys. Racing to the back.
I'm not racing.
So what we have here is the classic Weber grill. Only we got a duck. Ducks are bigger. All right, so we're gonna have to modify things a little bit here. So we're gonna build a fire, put our coals underneath the coal grate, and put our ducks on the coal grate itself.
We have to drink a little bit of them, is the way this goes.
Superstition, bad luck if you don't.
Yeah, cheers.
We have the neck that we trimmed off going on the Pilsner. Ooh, buddy. All right, so we're all set up here. We have our coals offset to one side. The whole idea is that they're just gonna radiate heat and that the grill itself will stay at about 275, 300. It's gonna take our time. It's gonna take about 2 hours. The whole idea is that they're standing up, so they're gonna cook really evenly, and a lot of that fat is going to drip off so that we get crispy skin.
Yeah.
Cross them fingers.
All right. Now remember how you bought all those beers because you just had to put one inside of a duck? You have 2 hours to kill. So, see you later.
So we're about halfway through. It's been an hour. We're gonna check on our ducks and see if they need to be turned at all to cook a little bit more evenly.
Oh.
Whoa. This looks fantastic. Okay, so we're browning on the backside. Looks really nice.
Great turn.
Oh yeah. This is going great.
Anything that isn't a raging fire, thumbs up. All right, back to your beer.
See you in an hour.
Okay, the ducks are just about done.
Skin looks great, color's beautiful. I mean, it looks gorgeous. I'm very, very excited about this.
Yeah.
So we're gonna wanna take them off, let it rest for about 10 to 15 minutes or so.
Duck time, the tasting.
Let's cut this first. I think this one actually retained a little bit more fat. It's like still.
This guy's still.
Still rendering.
Yeah, still rendering.
So I think that this one we should slice first.
Sounds great.
Cool. It looks great. I'm very excited about the skin. Cooked all the way through. This is actually significantly different and way more exciting than the beer can chicken because the whole thing about the chicken is that the skin dries out and it becomes really difficult to actually carve. This all stayed together despite us separating the whole thing. It looks really good.
Really great flavor.
Skin isn't crispy, but it is rendered.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, it's like its own thing. I've never had this before. Yeah, I gotta say, this is intensely delicious, but not super crispy.
Yeah.
So while all of the skin is like really nicely rendered, let's try some of the backside seemed to like caramelize really quickly.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. That's crispy skin. Yeah, the thigh that we had from the less cooked side and then eating the like much more like mahogany color side, the difference in flavor and texture was pretty sizable.
Yeah. That was like decadent Thanksgiving turkey on steroids.
Yeah.
Delicious. Let's try this one with the IPA. I mean, let's see whether the beer has any difference. Yeah. We have all of that neck skin. It's totally different.
Yeah. So you can feel like some pushback and some like crisp from the skin when you're cutting it.
Sure.
I don't know if it tastes like an IPA, but it tastes, I like it a lot.
But it tastes like amazing duck.
Yeah, it tastes really, really good.
I do gotta say, I've cooked plenty of beer can chickens on a can of Budweiser. And at the end, you taste Budweiser. This is way more smooth. The fact that you're like not tasting the beer, I think is actually a nice thing, because you wouldn't want that in the actual Coke. I think we're getting somewhere that actually we should, rather than going slower, lower, actually go a little hotter, faster, yep, in order to get more caramelization, get more color, to actually char it a little bit on the outside. I do think that separating the skin had a remarkable effect. Like, it rendered a lot of the fat.
Yes.
The presentation is absolutely fantastic.
Looks beautiful.
It's not the level of crisp that we were hoping for, but ultimately I think that's okay. Like, I think the next version would actually probably be better. We just have a slightly different approach.
Yeah, I think it would just be a little bit higher heat and less cook time, which who's gonna argue with that?
Right.
And you're gonna end up with a crispier skin and just as great of a flavor. Like, this is a phenomenal flavor, and I think you're kind of good to go.
Right. Also, I don't think, I don't know, what do you think about keeping the neck skin on?
I think that might be part of where, like, this, like, the kind of, like, real nice, like, delicateness of the meat and the texture might be coming
cooked
from.
A little bit more evenly?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the only way I can describe it. There were two birds of the same size sitting right next to each other.
Right.
That one shrunk a lot more. This one stayed a little bit bigger.
Right.
I think this cap really, really did help keep a lot of the flavor in.
This is like kind of a real like freaking whole animal experience though. Like, the breast is different from the leg, it's different from the neck, it's different from the wing. Like, depending on your preference, there's like a bite from everyone. Also, might want to mention that one duck can probably pretty easily feed four people.
Very easily.
Three bites and
I'm going to bed.
Yeah, this is super, super decadent.
I love chicken, I love duck, I love beer can chicken, I really love beer can duck. Can't lose. And that's how you get into art school.